Choice is to live in bondage of sin. We have a choice to do right or wrong. However you make your choice, it will be your declaration of independence. You made a decision on what you want to do. You have the liberty to live in the ways of God instead of living a stressed, frustrated, sinful life. There's freedom in serving God. You don't care what other people think about your love for Him. Your liberty is in Him. We need to make a declaration to God that we're going to serve Him no matter what comes or what goes. If we think about what Jesus gave up His life for, then we understand that His dying gave us an opportunity to be free. Be free from sins and live in a redemptive state. We should want to use the freedom and liberty we have to make sure we are connected to Christ. He died so we could be joined back together with God. Live right with the freedom we have now, not taking the freedom that we have and making the choices that we think we want to do for any occasion. That's what verse 13 says in Galatians 5 and 13. For brethren, you have been called unto liberty. You're free. Only use not the liberty for an occasion to the flesh, but by love serve one another. Good morning, everybody. Welcome to High Ground Christian Church. I'm Pastor James Ziegler. I want to give you a quick word. I don't want to hold you long, but I do want to tell you something that God gave me. But what we're first going to do, let me give you our vision statement, which is simply Colossians 3:1-2. It says, if then you have been raised with Christ, then seek the things that are above where Christ is, seated at the right hand of God. Set your mind on the things that are above and not on the things on this earth. I wholeheartedly believe in that. We get so just sidetracked and distracted with so many things that's going on with this world that we lose focus on God. Let me pray for you real quick. Lord, I thank you now for this day. Thank you for this morning. Thank you for the person that's on the line, God. Thank you for those who are hearing, God. Those who woke up this morning, I'm asking that you cover them and keep them. Keep their minds free from fault and free from stress, free from foolishness, God. From demonic spirit, I ask that you remove that right now. Let them hear a word today that will want their life to change. Keep us right now and breathe a fresh word on as you use me in Jesus Christ's name. Amen. Yeah. Listen, good thing today. This is a good word that God gave me. It's kind of funny, and I'll tell you how it came about. But basically, it's out of Galatians chapter 5, verses 1 and then 13. If you will, turn with me to Galatians chapter 5, verses 1. And then I have 13 and 16, but this is what the word says. It says, stand fast, therefore, in the liberty wherewith Christ has made us free. Good morning to all y'all. And be not entangled again with the bondage of yoke, the yoke of bondage. Let me read that again. Galatians chapter 5, verse 1 says, stand fast, therefore, in the liberty wherewith Christ has made us free. Remember the word liberty. And be not entangled again with the yoke of bondage. Verse 13 says, for brethren, ye have been called unto liberty. Here we go again with that word. And only use not liberty for an occasion to the flesh, but by love serve one another. And if you went to verse 16, it says, this I say then, walk in the spirit, and ye shall not fulfill the lust of the flesh. Today, if I were going to have a topic to my sermon, today the topic is the Declaration of Independence. Yeah, I know. You're like, how you get that preaching? The Declaration of Independence. I want you to know that you have the declaration. Listen, I first want to tell you that we all have a choice. Choices of what we will eat every day, choices of what we will wear every day. What I wore white today because I chose this the first Sunday of August. I just chose to wear it because I just wanted to wear this. Choices of what where we want to work or choices of where we want to live. We have choices of who we will marry and who we'll be in relationship with, whether it's friends or romance, whatever it is. We have a choice of what music we want to listen to, choices whether we want to watch TV or read a book. We even have a choice of what religion we would like to be a part of, choices to walk in liberty or of freedom, and even the choices to even live in bondage. That's crazy. Choices to live in bondage of sin. We have a choice to do right or wrong. However you make your choice, it will be your declaration of independence. You made a decision on what you want to do. Let me read again. Here's the scripture, Galatians chapter 5, verse 1. Stand fast, therefore, in the liberty wherewith Christ has made us free. Stand fast in the liberty in which Christ. Let me do this real quick. Let me give you the definition of liberty. I looked it up. You know how I like to look up words. Liberty. This is what the definition said. The state of being free within society from oppressive restrictions imposed by authority on one's way of life, behavior, or political views. Liberty, the power or scope to act as one pleases. The Declaration of Independence. Now let me read the scripture again. Stand fast, therefore, in the liberty. That means in the freedom, in the choice, within society, without being oppressed, without any restrictions imposed, in your own way of life, or your behavior, of your political view. Stand for in the liberty wherewith Christ has made you free. That's how you have liberty. And be not entangled again with the yoke of bondage. Now, you are already free from it, but sometimes we have a choice of what we want to do. Verse 13 says, for brethren, you have been called unto liberty. You've been called unto freedom within society from oppressing restrictions imposed by authority. So you can live how you want to in your life, your behavior and your political view. You have been called unto liberty. Only use not liberty for an occasion to the flesh. Only use not your freedom of how you feel in society, not being oppressed, restricted, you have authority on how you want to live. Don't use your liberty to sin. Only use not liberty for an occasion to the flesh. Don't use it to sin. This is your declaration of independence. But by love, serve one another. And listen, this I say then, walk in the spirit and ye not fulfill the lust of the flesh. This is your declaration. When in the course of a human event, I want you to tell you something here, because you know what liberty is. Now here you have it, that the Bible is talking about you having liberty. That means the Bible is saying that you have a freedom to live how you want to, act how you want to, walk where you want to, listen to what you want to do, a liberty to do as you please. You are free to make your own decisions. You have the Declaration of Independence. But what we must understand is that God allows us to choose how we want to live. But keep in mind that he gives us directions on how we should live. But it's your choice to live God's way or man's way. If you would allow me briefly, just real quick, to read a quick portion of the unanimous declaration of the 13 states of the United States of America. In your eyes, it's called the Declaration of Independence. This is what it says. When in the course of human events, it becomes necessary for one people to dissolve the political bands which have connected them with one another and to assume among the powers of the earth the separate and equal station to to which the laws of nature and nature's God entitle them. A decent respect to the opinion of mankind requires that they should declare the causes which impel them to the separation. We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal. I know that's funny, but this is in the Declaration of Independence, that they are endowed by the Creator with certain unalienable rights. That just means they can't be taken away, can't nobody take them from you or not. Unalienable rights, that among these are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. Have y'all heard that before? I just gave y'all the first portion of the Declaration of Independence. Now, this was written back on July 4th, 1776. Now, that's about 246 years ago. Now, I wasn't no big history buff when I was in high school. I didn't get into it, but more that I read the Bible, it brings me back to history. Because, listen, slavery started in 1619. Now, keep in mind, the Declaration of Independence was wrote on in 1776. Slavery started in 1619. That was 403 years ago. I actually wrote a sermon on it 3 years ago explaining that the curse is over. Just like God allowed Israel to be in slavery in Egypt for 400 years, same thing with us. Now the Bible was written about 400 BC, 400 BC to 1450 BC. That was about 3,400 years ago. But I bring this up. The only reason I bring this up, because they both speak of having liberty. This is the only reason that I bring up the history of when the Bible was written in the Declaration, because they both speak of having liberty. But there's a difference that I want to explain about your liberty. Yeah, man. See, you can have liberty in this country by man and do what you want to do, because it's your thing. Do what you want to do. I can't tell you. That's the song. And listen, oftentimes there's no real consequences behind your liberties with man. Yeah. Sin is so rampant nowadays that we allow anything against what God says. We allow all kinds of things against what God says is wrong. We make it right. Sin is rampant nowadays. But when it comes to God, you almost have the same model. It's your thing. Do what you want to do. But the consequences of your actions with God is that you may miss having everlasting life with him. You may miss getting your heavenly home. You may miss your mansion because you missed the mark down here. See, nowadays, it seems like people don't mind taking that chance. People don't mind riding the fence. We feel like if he is a God of forgiveness, then he'll forgive me of my sins in the end. That's wrong thinking. That's how we think about it. We think, oh, that we ain't got no consequences when it comes to God, because he loves us and we're going to have a second chance. So we choose to live how we want to. Well, I want you to know that if you continue in your sins knowingly, then you're living in iniquity, and you can care less about what he thinks right now. So I'm asking you this. What if he feels the same way in the end? What if God says, I don't care about how you feel about it. I don't care that you thought I was going to be forgiven in the end. You didn't care when you were living your life. So why should he care when you lose it? You have made a Declaration of Independence and have chose to roll the dice on how you see things in hope that your thoughts will be correct in the end, that God is going to forgive you and give you a second chance. Even though you knew it was wrong and the way that you were living was wrong, you decided, I'm going to make a chance, a choice, because I have liberty. I have liberty to live how I want to. But let me tell you what I'm doing today. I want to preach redemption. I want to preach redemption to you now that you can use your liberty in a productive way of life. Now don't be upset with me. I'm not going to be here all day. I'm almost done, as a matter of fact. But I want to preach redemption for you. For life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. But I want it in Christ. Not for what man said. not for how man sees we should have life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness, but how God sees it. See, I want you to be happy, but I would rather you to have joy every day. See, people can make you unhappy and irritate you if they make you angry. But if you have joy, nobody can take that away from you. And I see people walking around with joy every day where nothing can make them throw them off course and get their mind off. You have a liberty to walk around with a smile on your face, no matter what is going on in your life. Yeah, listen. I also want you to be physically fit. I want your body to look good. I want you to be walking around, you know, not a whole lot of weight on you or anything. I want you to be physically fit for any occasion, but I'd rather you be healthy. Healthy spiritually and healed of any sickness, because you can be physically fit and still be sick. No, man, I know. You have a declaration of independence. Everybody goes and works on their body, but nobody works on the spirit man. Mm. Lord, let my spirit man be stronger than my flesh man. Yes, I want you to have all the knowledge in the world and be one of the smartest people to ever walk on the earth. But I'd rather you use godly wisdom through life so you don't take your knowledge and do the wrong things with it. If you use your godly wisdom, it will elevate your knowledge to help bless God's people, not for your selfishness. I understand you don't like being around people and you like living alone in a quiet space, but I'd rather you have peace within. That if you have this peace, no matter who you're around, God will still give you a peace of mind. I don't care if you're on your job. I don't care where you're at. I don't care if somebody died. You're going to have a peace of mind, knowing that God is going to make a way. This is a declaration of independence of how you think. I bring all of this up because you have the liberty to live in the ways of God instead of living a stressed, frustrated, sinful life. There's freedom in serving God. You don't care what other people think about your love for him, because you know that no other human being, no other human man can give you what God gives you. And no matter what other man can even save your life like the Son of God, your liberty is in him. We need to make a declaration to God that we're going to serve him no matter what comes or what goes. If we think about what Jesus gave up his life for, then we understand that his dying gave us an opportunity to be free. Be free from sins and live in a redemptive state. As a matter of fact, I didn't have a whole lot of scriptures today, but I have one right here. I'm almost done. Ephesians 1:7 says, in him we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of our trespasses according to the riches of his grace. See, this was a decision that was made to purchase your freedom with his blood. And if we look at it for what it is, then we should want to make good on the opportunity to be free in him, not to live in a devilish way. A lot of us like to live in this sinful life and have all these demonic spirits around us, and not in a devilish way that we choose. We're talking about taking advantage of the system. Yes, you have the freedom to do what you want, but as we know, there are consequences to your actions. Let me give you an example. I'm going to talk about something that's going on today. It's real controversial, but I'm going to speak on it. There's a young lady over in Russia right now, a basketball player over in Russia. Y'all know who it is. I won't call her name or anything, but she's over there right now for something she did. She broke a law, all right? They gave her 9 years. Now, whether I think it's too much and excessive or not, she broke a law. She had a declaration of independence of what she wanted to do, and she did it. Knowing where she was, knowing the situation, I know, and everybody don't look at it the same. Oh, everybody looking at this as a white or black issue. No, this ain't a white or black issue. This is a wrong or right issue. And this is what problem is nowadays. We try to take things that are wrong and make them right just because we're trying to push our own agenda. We have a declaration of our own independence. Now, do I want over there? No, that's not what I'm saying. Do I feel bad? Yes, I do. Do I wish things would change? Yes, and God can do. But I look at this as just wrong and right. If you know that they don't allow certain things where you are, then why take the chance? Because you know you have to face the consequences for what you chose to do with your liberty. You chose it. So same thing with God. We know that some of these things that we're doing are illegal to God. It's spiritually. We know we ought not do it in God's eye, and we still choose to sin and then expect people to go to war over your actions. No, 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 no. You sit there and collect your thoughts while you deal with the consequences of your actions. Change your mindset and make a new declaration for your life. Now, on that subject, I pray that the young lady gets home. I pray that our government be able to do something with their government and get her back home. But I want you to know, listen, no, I don't think we should go to war over that. No, I don't. You made a decision, just like some of y'all make a decision every day to sin. And when we have our repercussions, when God does some things to us in our life, then we crying out, woe is me, God. Why me? Why you doing? No. Because of your freedom, because of your liberty, because of your declaration of independence, you think you can do what you want to. Change your mindset and make a new declaration for your life. God, I know I have freedom, but I want to stop lying. I know I have a freedom, God, but I want to stop stealing and cheating and cursing, adultery, fornication, gluttony, greed, and most of all, God, disobedience. No, I have a declaration of a new independence where I don't want to do any of that. I'm free to put all that stuff to the side. God, help me to change the way I use my freedom and the liberty that I may be better in how I live and how I give. Change my heart from just fighting for things that I know are wrong, just to try to make them right for my own liberty. God, help me. I want to live in the way that you want me to live, not in the way that the world sees it, not the Declaration of Independence that was written on July the 4th. No. I want to live how your word says. We should want to use the freedom and liberty we have to make sure we are connected to Christ. He died so we could be joined back together with God. And here we are, we're in a country where we can serve how we want to, be free how, but yet we choose to sin and take advantage of the opportunity to love God right now. Let me read another scripture to you real quick. Romans chapter 6. Go to Romans chapter 6. I'm going to start at verse 5. It says, for if we have been planted together in the likeness of his death, we shall be also in the likeness of his resurrection. Knowing this, that our old man is crucified with him, that the body of sin might be destroyed, that henceforth we should not serve sin. For he that is dead is freed from sin. Now, if we be dead with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. Knowing that Christ, being raised from the dead, dieth no more. Death has no more dominion over him. Though I love that. For in that he died unto sin once. But in that he lives unto God. So that's forever. Likewise, verse 11 says, likewise, reckon ye also yourself to be dead indeed unto sin, but alive unto God through Jesus Christ our Lord. Let not sin therefore reign in your mortal body, that ye should obey it in lust thereof. Listen, I'm about to be done. We must want to change our sinful lives so that we may be free in God to live our lives with him one day. If the old you has died to Christ, then the old you killed the sin that you were living with. So why then do we pick up the dead things that Jesus has already killed off? He won't do it again. It said he only did it once. He won't do it again. So we need to take heed to the opportunity we have. now and live right with the freedom we have now, not taking the freedom that we have and making the choices that we think we want to do for any occasion. That's what verse 13 says in Galatians 5 and 13. For brethren, you have been called unto liberty. You're free. Only use not the liberty for an occasion to the flesh, but by love, serve one another. Listen, the devil is busy. He's rampant. And now that you know about your own declaration of independence, he's on everybody to get you to make a decision to sin. He wants to see you destroyed by your own declaration of independence. Even though Jesus died so that we may be free, it was so that we may be free from the bondage of sin. Be not entangled again with the yoke of bondage. Be free from it. We need to fight these everyday demonic spirits. Speaking of that, I heard one of my sisters preaching this morning, Elder Era Harris. She was speaking about demonic spirits and demons and how they come in your sleep. Let me tell you something, and how they come in your dream. It just happened to me last night. You know what? I'm going to go on and testify that right now. I don't mind even telling you. I got home last night. No problem. Nobody was here. My kids was all gone. I'll go on ahead and go to bed so I can get my sleep, get my rest, be ready for the day. All of a sudden, some demonic spirits start fighting with me in the middle of my dream, putting stuff in my head, crazy stuff. I jump up. Let me tell you, this is why I said, if then you have been raised with Christ and seek the things above where Christ is, seated at the right hand of God, set your mind on the things above and not on the things on your earth. I jump up immediately, start walking around the house. Now I find that two of my kids are at home. Thank God, because the weather was horrible last night. I thank God. All right, they're at home. But I feel these spirits in my home. I get the oil immediately. They probably thought I was crazy. They ain't heard me talking like this. And no, get the oil and started blessing the house, walking around, declaring who God is in my declaration of independence, knowing that he makes a way. I made two of them get up, go wash the dishes, clean up the house, get these nasty, go. I went and opened up the front door. Get these nasty spirits out of here. Let me tell you something. One of the things about us nowadays, we're scared to even deal with our own kids. We have a declaration of our independence, thinking that it's for us and they're going to make it. No. God didn't do that. God put us in place for a reason. And if he's going to give us a declaration of independence, of freedom, we need to be free to tell people that we love God, even our family. Pray over your family. Pray over your kids. Get the demonic spirits out. Some of us are fighting with demonic spirits and don't know why. Get up and bless your house. Hey, have the freedom of spirit. If they have the freedom to go do what they want to, run where they want to, do what they want to, no. We have a freedom to pray over them. We have the freedom to bless God over them. Bless our house. No, we ain't bringing the spirits in our house. We're not going to do that. Push them spirits out. It got to start with you, though. In the declaration of your independence, be free, have liberty in God. Feel and get bold about it, just like everybody else is bold about how they live. If they want to live sexually how they want to, if they want to smoke this and do that, they want to go where they want to do. Listen, be bold about how Jesus died for you, and he died for you to be free. So I know I'm saying something. Somebody gonna get upset about it, but let me tell you, there's repercussions to your actions. In every situation, every circumstances, however you live, whether even if you go by the Declaration of Independence of the United States, there's some repercussions. And so here it is. I'm telling you about the Declaration of Independence in the spirit, what God gave. Stand fast, therefore, in the liberty, in your freedom, wherewith Christ has made us free. And be not entangled again in the bondage of sin. Get that junk out of there. Even if you go somewhere, now pray them spirits out of there. Be careful and be bold and don't be scared about it. I know my kids thought I was about plumb crazy last night, walking around. Then I went in my room and just prayed hard. And guess what? As soon as I finished, I laid back down and went straight to sleep. Every spirit that was in there had to leave. I made a declaration of independence of who I was serving and wasn't scared about it. Get on out of here. Let me get my rest and get my sleep. And it can happen for you. We just got to make a declaration. The declaration of our independence that we love God enough to serve him and stop sinning. I know it happens every now and then, but it's too many people nowadays living in iniquity where we know it's wrong and we choose to live there. We choose to keep sinning. We choose to be disobedient. Let me tell you, and everything, whether it's on your job, they're going to have rules and regulations. And if you break those rules, there are consequences. I don't care where you go. If you're driving without a license or without a seatbelt, there's rules and consequences. There's going to be a consequence for it. Same thing with God. There are consequences to your actions. Yeah, you have a freedom to do it. And you can ride without your seatbelt. You can drive 100 miles per hour if you want to. You got the freedom to do it. You have the liberty to do it. But when they catch you, just know that there are consequences for it. If you don't pay your light bills at home, there's consequences. They're going to cut the lights off. That's it. Nothing more, nothing less. If you don't pay your car bill, they're going to pick it up. There's a declaration of independence that we are not aware of. We're not taking advantage of. Be free, but be free not unto the occasion of to the flesh, where you think you can do what you want to and things not change. No, that's not how it works. Have a declaration of independence. Now, I said a little bit more than what I wanted to this first Sunday. I don't want to even jump into all that, but listen, the reason that we preach these sermons is because of Romans chapter 10, verse 9, that if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, yes, God, and believe in thy heart that God has raised him from the dead, then thou shalt be saved. I want you saved, and he died to save all of us, but we have to make a declaration of independence that we're going to live for God, live free for him. Not even worry about it. Not even sweat it. You know how you just say, that's it. I'm tired of it. That's it. That's how I felt last night when I was telling these demons, get out of here. You don't have no authority here. It won't happen again. Don't come in here no more. And the devil, listen, the devil knows he ain't that strong. You know, you could talk to him and make him leave. And make all his demons leave. The only problem is we scared of the devil. We're more scared of the devil than we are of God. The devil's scared of God. And when I say scared of God, I don't mean like in a way, oh, he gonna beat me up. I'm saying scared of him in knowing that, hey, I wanna be with him in my life for the rest of my life. I don't wanna lose my life not living with the liberties that Jesus Christ died for me to have. Oh, I know. I may sound angry. Don't get me wrong. I'm just speaking in an authoritative tone because I had to move some demons out. I want to move the demons out of your life. Have a declaration of independence. Have some liberty over what Jesus gave. Oh, man. I'm not going to be more scared than the devil than I am of God. The devil is trying to get us to make the mistakes, to get our eyes off of God. He wants us. I was telling a friend of mine this at work the other day, and I love her to death. I told her, hey, he is trying to distract you. He knows what you're trying to do. He knows you're trying to live for him. He knows you've made a declaration of independence, that you want to walk more in his ways. Oh, so he's going to come. And most of the time, guess what? He comes through our family. This is what the preacher was talking about this morning. I said he likes to come through our family mostly. He'll come early in the morning. Be waiting up for us. Oh, she made a point that happened to me before. He'll make you and your spouse argue coming out of church. Go to church, hear the word of God, and come straight out and still be into it. That's because the devil is rampant. He wants to distract you from even what you hear today. He's going to send something, and maybe that's what he came for last night. He did not want me to tell you that you have the liberty to serve God in a way that pleases God. The Declaration of Independence, don't get that flipped out and tripped out about the Declaration of Independence here in the United States and think that you got a freedom to do what you want to. There's still consequences and repercussions to your actions. Oh, I want you to be free. I really do. Brethren, you have been called into liberty, and only use not liberty for the occasion of your flesh, but love, serve one another. but by love, serve one another. This I say then, walk in the spirit, and ye shall not fulfill the lust of the flesh. Forgive me. I got excited about this short sermon, but I wanted to hear about your declaration of independence. Serve God, use it freely. Use it. We live in a country where we can serve God freely. And some of us now have changed that. Yeah, we have changed it because we're so free. Now we want to think how we want to, do what we want to, live how we want to, and think ain't nobody going to say nothing. Oh, no. Don't think that's how it's going to be. No matter what you have, everything has some rules and consequences and to your actions. Just know that. When you're disobedient and you choose to do what you want to do, oh, man, there's some consequences. You made the Declaration of Independence. You chose to work where you want to, live where you want to, marry who you want to, walk how you want to, look at what you want to, listen to what you want to. Yeah, you chose that. Even the bondage of sin, you chose it. Choose Christ, though. Choose to live in with joy and peace and love and kindness. I like to use this as an example. Let God, with all his blessings, work through you to bless other people. Let God, with all his blessings, work through you to bless other people. I know you want what's up here. I'd rather have all this little gold. This ain't even sand. This is little gold pieces. I want all that gold, and I want all of it down here too. Got a little sparkle. But how about if God continues to bless you and work through you? He's going to keep blessing. Oh, you may not get it in a lump sum just to sit in your bank account. You may not have it in your savings account, but he just keep flowing blessings through you constantly so that you can bless other people. It's a declaration of independence that he has with us, the liberty that he has to bless you continuously. It's just going to keep flowing and keep flowing and keep flowing. But some of us, we don't like to give and we don't like to bless people, but we want the blessing. Let God work through you. And let me tell you something. As soon as it starts running out and you don't think you have no more, he just flips it back upside down and starts blessing you again. Now we're blessing some other people, but it's all coming through you. Don't let it be used selfishly. No. Man, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to get off on all that. Listen, if you want to be a blessing to the church, do it through our Cash App, Money Sign, HIGHERGROUNDCC. We have PayPal, we have Givelify. Let the Lord use you. Use your Declaration of Independence for good. Listen, today it's first Sunday, and listen, I want to explain something about taking the Holy Communion. When you take it, you should be in a mindset, have a Declaration of Independence and your liberty. You should be in a mindset to thank Jesus for what he's done. Remember him. He said, do this in remembrance of me. Let you not have some all kind of different spirits on the inside of you trying to do the same thing. No, pray that stuff out of that. Have a declaration to move with the liberty out of that. Listen, I do have a song real quick. I'm going to play the song. So if you are going to take the Lord's Supper with me, get yourself prepared. This song is by Keontae Gavin, and it just says, hold me close. Hold me close, Keontae Gavin. This music does not belong to me.
Keep on singing and keep singing. I don't wanna live for you and not see you in the end. I don't wanna know your name. You not know much before I get to the gate. Please hold. Keeping on.
God, whatever you do, you know, keep my family, hold me close. Listen, let me be brief. Listen, in the last days, Jesus was talking to his disciples and he was giving them instruction. And he said, listen, when I leave here, he took some bread, he broke it, he blessed it. Lord, I ask that you bless this food for the nourishment of the body in Jesus Christ's name. He said, this represents my body. As often as you do this in remembrance of me. He took it, broke it, blessed it, and they ate. At the same token, he had a thing of wine. He said, this is the new revelation of my blood. He took it, he blessed it. Lord, bless us. Let it nourish our bodies, God, in remembrance of Jesus. He gave the disciples, he said, this represents my blood. He blessed them. He said, as often as you do this in remembrance of me. Drink. And they went out saying, I'm not gonna sing today, but I didn't exalt all my little energy preaching about the Declaration of Independence. Let me tell y'all something. I wish y'all could have saw me fighting them demons last night and how they was running, trying to get out of here. I'm talking about I could feel them scrambling, like, what the heck? We didn't cave in the wrong house accidentally, because they ain't been here in a while. And you know what? Some of y'all can probably even attest to that sometimes you could feel demonic spirits in your house. Even in your dreams and things of life, get up, get you some oil and pray them out of them. They have no authority over us. We have a declaration of independence, of liberty through Christ, which is way stronger than what Satan think he has. He got kicked out of heaven. Yeah, he got kicked out. And why would I even listen to him? He has no authority and no power. Amen. Listen, I appreciate you taking the time. I hope you got something out of it. I know it seemed like it was a lot, but I hope you got something out of it. And it's not the most in-depth sermon I ever preached, but we have a declaration of independence that I want you to know about. Live in your freedom for Christ. Amen. Enjoy your week. Enjoy what you have coming on. Listen, I won't be here Tuesday, but I will preach again on Thursday. I want to preach on Thursday and give this word. So I want you to come back and hear a little bit more of it and hopefully have a better understanding of the Declaration of Independence. I love you. Enjoy your week. God bless you. And I appreciate your time. Y'all have a good day. Enjoy your Sunday.